I'm officially retired after picking this up. I'm feeling it. Number one steal. Might be the last load.
Still holding on.
Oh. The old back didn't like that one, but we're gonna celebrate early. Got the number one steal. We might be all done. Got a new item to try. My favorite place. Nothing else to get here. See what we got here. We got the new chicken croissant. Ooh. Looks like a piece of fried chicken on there. Bacon and cheese. Good amount of bacon. I like the croissants, but I end up with the flakies in my beard for the rest of the day. I can't get them out. I like when they slightly toast the croissant, just a little bit. Sometimes they just microwave it. It's all soggy. Try this out. The chicken, it's not crispy, you know, it's kind of soggy a little bit, the breading's a little bit soggy, but, see, croissant flakes. I mean, for Dunkin' Donuts, you know, it's not a bad sandwich, I guess. Definitely white meat chicken. Well, that shop I was talking about, that whole ordeal with that kid and the truck and a parts truck and all that horse shit. They ended up needing me. They always need you. Town came down on them. Too much junk out there. They had a bunch of truck beds and crap everywhere. They don't have a truck on the road or anything to get rid of stuff. Not even to take stuff to the dump or anything. So, called me up. Broken Dreams. Always comes to the rescue. Pick up the pieces. Shattered pieces. Had to clean it up for him. That piece in the back is a piece to an old lift for lifting vehicles. One of like the center post ones that you drive over. Old style. It was in that garage when they moved in. That was sitting out in the driveway. It took four guys to move it. They wanted me to take it, so I said, well, you're going to have to help. three of us got it in there, barely. So before I went there, I went to the oil company that I clean up because they had a bunch of barrels like that one in the back here. And one of the things that the guy from the town said on that repair shop is that you can't put the junk on the ground. They don't want it sitting on the ground. You have to put it in something. You have to have an old trailer, you know, or a container or something that contains it all, because they don't want a big pile of shit looking like crap. And then, of course, the hazardous liquids and, you know, stuff that comes out of it. So I figured maybe I could come up. See, I'm thinking, always thinking, for the next hustle. Lots of people go by their shop trying to get scrap, and I think they end up giving some people the rotors and stuff, because never really a lot there, and I know they do a lot of brakes. Well, I want those rotors. I want the junk, so I went to the oil company, and I was going to get them a couple of these barrels. They could throw the junk in there, keep it neat, and then I could maybe, they would call me to come and empty them if I, you know. So that's what I was thinking. But then I got over to the oil company, and they had cut an oil tank, a 275-gallon oil tank, right in half. So I said, perfect. I took that over there, and I said, hey, I got something for you. And they were happy as hell. So I set it right in a nice spot beside their building, and now they can put all the junk in there, and hopefully they'll call me to clean it out, but I'll stop by there every now and then. So I got them their container, and then picked up that heavy chunk that they needed out of the way. And that's it. It's a nice day. 55 degrees. Chicken and bacon croissant. Dunkin' Donuts. Pretty good. Maybe healthier? I don't know. Could be slightly healthier than the sausage that I usually get. I tell you, egg on that wouldn't be too bad. Maybe add an egg on there. Could be a little extra protein for the day. So, guess we'll see what else the day brings. There you go. Flake beard.
up after what we'll do is where he's packed. I'll go, we'll just unload it right there beside the black truck.
All right.
How does that look like? It's in good shape, don't it?
I don't know. I didn't really look at it too close, but I'm probably going to have to pull it off with a chain with one of your, with a truck or something.
I got a winch on the Jeep.
Yeah, because it's a flat on the trail there, you know?
Yeah.
But I yanked her up there. It didn't go too bad.
Yeah, you want the trailer back?
I don't think so.
Yeah, want me to leave it under it for now? And then I don't want the trailer. You can have that for scrap, too.
Yeah, I mean,
no good to me. I got a snowmobile trailer. It'll be quiet.
Yeah, you want to leave it under there for now? It's up to you.
Whatever, yeah, we can. Yeah.
However you want to do it.
Yeah, easier that way. Thank you.
Thank you.